This is the animation of one wind turbine within a wind farm space. It may look very simple, but this took several minutes and occupies several gigabytes of memory space. So yes, it's computationally expensive. So imagine if you are going to put in 20 wind turbines and try to model it. Hi there and welcome to Cat Metal Resources. This is part 7 on the series on the use of OpenFAST. Here we are going to look at the layout and visualization of wind farms. We'll be looking at maximizing power in a wind farm. We'll visualize the wind farm. Then we'll have a sample guide of how animation should look. Then we'll compare wind data patterns and control volume. Lastly, we are going to look at what SOWFA is and how we can use it to generate wind data models. There are several online courses which are free for wind energy technology, and I've posted a link for that in the description. But basically, when two wind turbines are placed one in front of the other, as soon as the first wind turbine extracts energy from the wind, there's a reduction in velocity immediately after the wind turbine. It takes some distance for that wind to actually recover to the initial wind speed. So there are some experiments which talk about between 5 diameter distance or 10 diameter distance for it to take for the wind to recover. So in most cases, if you place a wind turbine directly behind another turbine, you may not generate as much power as the first turbine in the line. So there are different calculations, as I've shown here, on how to actually find the kind of wind speed you get behind wind turbines. So considering the fact that the wake can be affected by wind turbines, it's important to know how to put the layout for wind turbines in both the horizontal and vertical direction, or we'll say longitudinal and lateral directions. So in this series, we're actually looking at the Fast Farm user documentation, which has more specific information for wind farms. So you can see here in this schematic how some wind turbines were arranged for the Fast Farm documentation, which is some of the examples that they use to explain the concept. Also, for the wake, sometimes you may have wind turbines facing different orientation. Probably the wind turbine at the front is inclined while the one at the back is horizontal. You can see that you need more dynamic calculations as opposed to what I showed on the first slide of how to calculate the velocity of the wind behind the first turbine. So you need more multi-dimensional calculations, which is done by the dynamic wake calculation of Fast Farm. So with respect to visualization, you have the VTK files as usual, and is used to contain wind data for both visualizing and for use in the modeling of the wind turbine forces and the effects on the wind. So you can see to the right the various VTK file types and the different schematics and what you can generate. So basically, for the wind data, you actually have control volumes. The large cuboid you see here is for the low resolution data, and the smaller cube is for the high resolution data. So you can see on the right some of the different parameters used to generate that control volume. There are different descriptions which you can find in the Fast Farm documentation. So it talks about how to put grid lines along it. So as before, the input files are the .date files, the .fst files, and the .fstl file, which is the Fast Farm file. Then you also need to update the VTK files. It may not be that direct, but it's one of the files that need an update. There are about 3 different code samples from OpenFAST, which models different kinds of wind farms. But basically, there are different wind models, one of which uses a VTK, the second one uses turbulent simulations, and the last one is a combination of different options. So you can see here, we are going to change the mode of ambient wind to 1, which is going to use the VTK file format. And then you can see how you need to update the number of wind turbines in this section. So if you are using mode of ambient wind as 1, you don't need the last columns, you just need the first 3 columns to fill in your information. So you can see here the VTK files and the data in it. You have 3 dimension wind speed, as well as some other information, which is what you generate from another application for the VTK wind data. So you see that the values are a lot. It's not something that you can just open and begin to change values manually. You need to use another software to generate it. So when you run the .fsta file, it actually automatically also runs the .fst file. So it runs both of them together, as you will see. So we are going to visualize both the wind turbine and the wind farm wind behavior and pattern. So this is for the wind turbine. We've selected the visualization. Then we come to fast farm, where we are going to select the ambient wind to be either 1 or 2, whatever we are looking at. Then we select visualization to be true. Then in this case, we just want to see an XY plane of the wind behavior around the wind turbine. So when you run the fast.farm file, you actually see two folders created. These folders are the VTK file for the wind turbine, as well as the VTK underscore FF file for the fast farm visualization files. So sample guide for wind farm animation, because there is not so much information available in the documentation of how the animation should look. There's a forum on NREL's website which discusses animation of wind farms. There are several pages from which people can actually go through and learn how people have troubleshooted previous problems. As you look at the problems they've troubleshooted, it's possible to learn some things of how to generate your own wind farm animation. Also, there's a video animation from National Center for Supercomputing Applications on the wind farm animation. You can actually check out the video to know how to probably tweak your own animation, probably to look like what it is here. You can see how large the wind farm is, about 11 kilometers by 3 kilometers by 2 kilometers. So you can see the various way the animation has been done from that institute. Ambient wind model options you have for option 1, option 2. There are 3, 4, and 5, but option 1 has to do with high fidelity VTK format, while option 2, which is the ambient 2, has to do with the general inflow wind model, which is the turbulent simulation. So these two kind of wind data are different. The first one has to do with the low eddy simulation, which is LES, and the other one is the general turbulent simulation. You can see that on the left you have the high fidelity VTK format, and on the right you actually have the regular turbulent simulation. You can see that on the left you actually see the development of the wind, while on the right it just shows you a past development of the wind. It doesn't show you how the wind moved over time around the blade. So in order to generate, because you can see that this control volume actually looks small, but you actually need much larger. Let's say you want to have 20 wind turbines, you need much larger than what OpenFAST actually provides. So you actually need to generate your own wind data with different dimensions. In order for that to be done, you need SOWFA. So you can see there's a tutorial online of how to use SOWFA, which has been linked in the description. This is a picture of what the cover looks like. From that training, you'll be able to know the different applications that you need to install and how to run it. So as a prerequisite to use SOWFA, you actually need OpenFOAM in order to then go ahead and run SOWFA on the system. So with this, you'll be able to generate wind data specific files for the VTK in order to run an animation or a wind model simulation for different wind farms other than what has been done by OpenFAST. Thank you for watching this video. This is Catchment of Resources, where we create for better living.